Welcome everybody to another video. This time it will be challenging. Lots of grammar things here because we are going to speak about four types of questions. Really? Are there so many types of questions? Yes. So let's see what you know about forming questions in English. So, first type of question is the direct question. As you already know, a direct question takes the form of a sandwich. You put the person in the middle, an auxiliary, and a verb. Yes? So, you wear glasses. The auxiliary you use there will depend on the tense. If you want to speak about present, if you want to speak about the past or the future. So, what are the auxiliaries in English? For the present, do, does. For the past, did. For the future, will. Nice. Yes? So depending on the tense, you will use one or the other. Let's suppose it's in the present. Do you wear glasses? Yes, every day. Okay. Again, in the present, but not you, Tom. Oh, does, yeah, remember this. Does Tom look happy? All right, this is present, but it's not simple present because I have ing, looking at me. Yes, very good. Is Tom looking at me now at this moment? So mind you, sometimes the verb be is an auxiliary. Okay. In the past, and we don't have a sandwich because we have the verb be. The verb be does not always take the sandwich. So, where were you this morning? Beautiful, simple, and easy. Okay. Next month. Let's see if you remember. The auxiliary for the future. Will. What will you do next month? Yes. Sometimes I have another word, for example, an adverb in the middle. Don't worry, look for the sandwich. And this is always in the present. So do we always have glasses? One more. Oh, God, careful there. Been, present perfect. Have or has? Yes. How long have you been friends? And sometimes I can ask about the ability, suppose. So in that case, I need a modal. Can penguins fly? As simple as that. What other modals do you know? Can, could, must, should, yes, all of them. Yes, they simply, you simply put it there. So, for a direct question, you have the possibility of using all of the auxiliaries or the verb be. Yes? Are we? Were we? Let's go to type of question number two. Yes? Indirect question. And in this case, I want to transform a real question into a sentence. It works as a question because the person is going to tell me something, some information. But check the form. It's not a real question. I don't have a question mark. So, do we work here? Assuming it's in the present. Tell me if you work here. And the person will say yes. It's a question, but it does not take the form of a sandwich. No question mark. So tell me if you like bananas. Let's practice. Two or three. What has he been doing? Tell me. This time is not if. This time is what. Yes. And next, subject. He. And then the rest of the predicate. Has been doing. Exactly. So tell me what he has been doing, please. One more. When was the Mona Lisa painted? Oh, do you know? Tell me, please. When? Subject? The Mona Lisa. Yes, it. To make it shorter. Was painted. Well, tell me when it was painted, please. Perfect. Type number three. We have already covered this. So you, yes, I'm sorry. We know how to form question tags. Yes, do we know? Do we know? Don't we? Yes. The idea is you think of the normal question in your head and shorten it. If it is in the positive, you put it in the negative. Don't we? And the question tag. Question mark. Let's practice. Two or three. He called you. So I form the complete question. Did he call? He called. Didn't he? Nice. One more. Oh, apparently he has seen that movie. So for the question, has he seen the movie? Hasn't he? Good. It was cold yesterday. Good, wasn't it? Yes. The last one. They need new clothes. Okay, I have to form the question in my head. Don't they? Yes. So, summary of these three. For direct questions, you have the sandwich. With the auxiliary, you need do for the present, did, or whatever. For the indirect questions, you form something like a sentence in a sentence. Sentence, subject and predicate, we, and then you put if, when, where, depends. And for question tags, don't we, or depending on the question. Always look at the first part of the sentence. Yes, of course. Okay, the last one. We are going to form short embedded questions. Oh my God, too much of a name for something simple, believe me. What should I do? Okay, this is a normal question. I want to make it shorter. I wonder what? What to do? Yes, I wonder what to do. If you are a Spanish speaker, this would be something like, me pregunto qué hacer. What to do? I need the question word and the infinitive. What to do? Yes, as simple as that. Let's practice. Where do I go? I don't know any other kind of expressions. I would like to know where to go. Where to go? Question word, infinitive. Where to go? Yes. One more to practice. How do I make coffee? How do I make coffee? I wonder how to make coffee. How to make coffee? Yes. One more. When do I start? I wonder when to start. Yes. Yes. One more and we finish. Who should I speak to? Who to speak to? Don't forget the second speak to. Yes? Nice. So, summary. To fix the ideas. Question, real questions, take the form of a sandwich. Then we have indirect questions, which take the form of a sentence. Yes? Then we have question tags, which take something like the first part of a question. We know, don't we? And now The short embedded questions? I know how to form short embedded questions. Yes, and you are ready to ask all types of questions now. Yes, thank you very much for your attention, and believe me, it takes time, patience, and practice. So go to the book, practice a lot. See you. Thank you.